I am not a liar. I have killed thousands. I have fed more drug fiends than the top three pharmaceutical companies combined. I have stolen children from parents, wives from husbands, wiped out entire generations. But lying? That I have never done. The rest are offenses against humanity. Lying is an offense against yourself. I am the head of the Santa Blanca organization, which you call a cartel. I had a dream. I dreamed of a land where we could grow our own coca, produce our own cocaine, where we could run our business free from interference from the police, the government, the army, the Yankees. In my dream, a woman's voice asked me,
"Sueño, mijo, what if you had your own country?"
Like Moses, I led my people to the promised land, Bolivia. We came here. We bought the coca fields. What we couldn't buy, we took. We bought the police, the military, the judges, the politicians. We were on the verge of becoming the government itself. On the razor's edge from fulfilling my dream. Of creating a narco-state. The nation of Santa Blanca.
Last week, a crude explosive detonated outside the U.S. Embassy in La Paz, Bolivia. Two Marine Embassy guards were injured in the blast. 2 days later, a CIA asset in central Bolivia provided us with these images. Our analysts have identified the individual in the photo as DEA Special Agent Ricardo Ricky Sandoval, my friend. Sandoval had spent the last 6 years investigating the local cocaine industry. Our understanding is that Sandoval was the intended target of the bombing. What the embassy bomb did not accomplish was completed up close and personal. Sandoval was captured, tortured, and killed. Then his body was dumped. We have yet to recover it. Our target, the group responsible for the embassy bombing and the death of Special Agent Sandoval, is the drug trafficking organization commonly known as the Santa Blanca Cartel. Yesterday, they were just narcos. Today, they're narco-terrorists. Initially, the Bolivian government resisted the Mexican cartel. They formed UNIDAD, a Bolivian Special Forces unit. It didn't go as planned. Thousands of bodies later, politicians, police officers, and journalists have become an endangered species. The Bolivian government has imploded on itself. With no other options, the new president made a deal with Santa Blanca. You stop killing our people, we'll look the other way. Since then, Santa Blanca has turned Bolivia into the nexus of the South American drug trade. With their friends in Mexico, they also have a clear pipeline to the U.S. and Canada. The only way to stop Santa Blanca for good is to completely dismantle them, piece by piece. The cartel is organized into four operations: production, smuggling, security, and influence. At the top of it all is El Jefe de los Jefes, boss of bosses, El Sueño.
The agent they murdered. You knew him?
He was a friend of mine.
Sorry for your loss.
I could say it comes with a job, but it doesn't get any easier.
No, it doesn't. Guess you've been down here a while?
I've been living as Karen Bowman, international aid worker, for just about 5 years. Means living rough, but as a cover, it gets me out and about.
At least it comes with a chopper.
How'd you get in country?
I flew in business class from Manaus.
Hey, I'm refreshed and ready for work, right? I just hitched rides from Barranco, Peru. How about you?
I got on board a bus in Huy, Argentina, and drank all the way to Villazón. Nobody wants to deal with a drunk on the bus.
That explains why you smell like ash.
I heard rumors about you guys. I was a rookie field officer in Moscow when the coup went down. There was talk you were involved?
Nah, it must have been someone else. We were never there.
It's not every day you get to meet an urban legend in the flesh.
You should tell that to my kid. Maybe he'd listen when I tell him to take the trash out.
Is it hard being someone who doesn't officially exist?
You tell me, Karen Bowman, international aid worker.
I'm sure you've seen the horrible, fucked up shit humans are capable of when there are zero repercussions. But let me tell you right now, no matter how you compartmentalize, how you desensitize, you can't prepare for El Sueño. He's got a religious streak that rates pretty close to delusional. He's taken vows of poverty, chastity. If he's not in it for the chocha or the money, he's in it for the power. This joint task force is CIA, DEA, JSOC. I'm your resident spook for this ride. Welcome to Operation Kingslayer.
Our briefing said there'd be a contingent of locals.
The Qatar is 26. They're a group of rebels who've been giving Unidad and Santa Blanca some resistance. We'll meet their leader, Pacatari, as soon as we touch down. Bolivians have a long history of hating us Yankees, but this time, let's hope the enemy of my enemy will be my friend. But don't turn your back on him. I'm not going to.
Soldiers. This is the help you promised, that Sandoval promised. A single Yankee died, so you send a handful of soldiers. Hundreds of Bolivians have died from Santa Blanca's bullets. Where will my hundreds of soldiers come from?
As Americans, we aren't here, remember? These soldiers are the best covert ops team our country has to offer. With their help, you won't need hundreds of soldiers.
Are you familiar with the word Huber, Senora Bowman?
Meet Pacatari, leader of the resistance group Qataris 26. We will be working with the rebels to destabilize Santa Blanca's organization. They've been fighting Santa Blanca and corrupt Bolivian officials for nearly 6 years now. We'll need to coordinate targets.
There is no time for this. We have information on Amaru's whereabouts.
Amaru? You found him? Amaru is one of the founders of the Qataris 26.
More than that, her group is founded on his ideas. Without his theories of an agrarian proletariat, there would be no organized resistance against Santa Blanca and the corruption in our government. Amaru must be saved. If you were to assist my people, it would do much to earn my confidence.
Where is he?
We do not know exactly. We know he is in this province and that there is a Santa Blanca lieutenant who knows where he is.
I'll put a call into the activity, see if they can dig more intel out of the airwaves. Start looking for that lieutenant and keep me informed of everything via sat phone. Good hunting.
Saving Amaru is important to our cause, Yankee. Make sure you don't kill the Santa Blanca lieutenant before you get the chance to ask him questions.
Time to earn your pay, people. Put on your game faces.
I tell you, I'm not too comfortable working with Pakatar and these rebels. Their kind of ideology always ends up with more bodies in the ground. What's your feeling on this op, Nomad?
End of the day, this is a revenge mission. We need to focus and get this done quick before we get stuck between local politics and a firestorm of cartel bullets. First objective, track down that Santa Blanca lieutenant so we can find the Maru.
Whoa. So this sub
I told we got hostiles in the area.
No, I haven't. I don't think I have. Anyway, so the sergeant is like... I guess that after you get out of here, you're just gonna sit around and wait for me to die so you can piss on my grave.
You've definitely told this one.
So the soldier replies, no, sir. After I leave the army, I'm never going to stand in line again.
Just spotted one with submachine guns.
Really? Nothing?
Don't want to spook the target. Switch to suppressors. Got eyes on the target. Let's move.
Pinche vato culero.
Moving to position. Ready. Call the shot.
That's a kill. Let the rebels know where to find these supplies. They could pay us back later.
We've got enemy activity nearby. Yo, cartel gunman, up in the watchtower.
Target down.
That was fucking close.
Got another tango.
Thank you. Careful. Sicario's sporting a submachine gun. Near the sandbag emplacement. Say the word. Tango is fucking down.
Coopere, todo saldrá bien.
Pinche cabrón.
Okay, we're still good.
Here's the deal, asshole. You answer my questions, or I put a bullet in your gut and leave you to die in your own shit. ¿Lo entiendes?
Chill the fuck out, cabrón. What do you want?
Amaru, where can I find him?
You serious? That's what this is about? Sure thing. He's at Atoya Farm. Go on. Then you can see what we do to people who fuck with us. People like you.
We need to get this done in a hurry. Amaru's an old man. He's not gonna last long under torture.
Shit, if they've been working on him for a while, there's a good chance he's already dead.
Maybe, maybe not. Amaru's a major player in the rebel movement. The cartel will keep him alive as long as they can to find out what he knows.
We can't afford to take any chances. There's too much riding on this. Let's move. Let's get moving. The cartel isn't going to wait around for us to track down and rescue Amaru.
Ready. Call the shot. Fire on these fuckers.
That's it, we're clear.
Better not roll this thing.
No problem. Aquí le prestamos. Come to the former offices of the mining consortium, and a dedicated loan officer will assist you. A lot of people have already taken advantage of this program, funding the purchase of equipment and supplies for the growing of...
We got company. Stay sharp. I got one narco. Front of the barn.
Drone is airborne.
spotting another Tango. And Baby makes three. Here's target number five.
Coming up on a Toyo farm. Remember, a lot of these Sicarios are ex-military.
ID your targets. If Amaru gets killed by a stray round, Operation Kingslayer will be dead in the water before it even starts. Let's go.
Yo, cartel gunman.
I don't see him.
In the field. Good to go. He's dead.
Tango down.
No mames. Esta pendejada es un pinche telescopio de juguete. Mira, pendejo, no estás pensando con cualquiera.
Hostile down. Frag out. Come in mierda, culeros. Engaging hostiles. You guys ready? Fire.
A copy.
Tango down. Hold up. There's a weapons case here.
No hostiles evident. Clear over here.
Nice. Are you Amaru?
What's left of him anyway?
Come on, we're getting you out of here.
Hey, ¿qué pasa?
There are a lot of lights and switches up here.
Where are you taking me?
Back to your friends.
Entonces Pacatari has made his deal with the malditos extranjeros, the young fool.
Take it up with him, senor. Check it out. Weapons case.
Hold on. Come up on.
This will go nice with my boots.
Are you hurt? Santa Blanca is not the most gracious of hosts. These Aucas, these demons, they had questioning me. Let us say, their talk of love was enough to make me vomit. But their methods were not...
Were their names Yuri and Polito?
Si, Yuri and Polito.
These are the fucks that tortured Ricky Sandoval while Sueño questioned him. I want them bad.
We only saw run-of-the-mill sicarios when we freed Amaru.
But I haven't seen Yuri and Polito in at least 3 days, maybe 4. I don't know where they are now.
We need more intel.
We'll search every village and camp until we find something.
Somebody's gotta know something. Gather documents, hack computers, interrogate hostile lieutenants, talk to civvies, whatever it takes.
We'll turn over every rock. Heads up. Bowman's file on Yuri and Polito is coming through. That's the rundown on La Yuri and El Polito. They're a key part of Santa Blanca's security operation. Remember to check out Bowman's briefing on their chain of command.
Guy in charge of security is El Muro, the Wall. Personal bodyguard and childhood friend to El Sueño. El Muro's little brother is La Plaga. Nasty piece of shit. Very active on social media. Head sicario for the cartel.
The hunt starts now. We want Sueño, we gotta work our way up the hierarchy. First targets are Yuri and Polito. We find the intel, we track them down, we take them out.
There were 4 people in the room the night DEA agent Ricky Sandoval was murdered. El Sueño, the head of the Santa Blanca cartel, Ricky, and the last 2 were La Yuri and El Polito. Yuri and Polito met at a poor state-run hospital in Chiapas, where El Polito was doing his residency and La Yuri worked as a nurse. It was love at first sight. From the first moment their eyes met, they were inseparable. A love like no other. One day, a buchan named La Plaga walked into the ER, all shot up. It was touch and go for a while, but Yuri and Polito were able to save his life. La Plaga was grateful. He showered them with gifts, invitations to the most exclusive parties, even a new car. And after a while, La Plaga made Yuri and Polito the personal medical staff of the Santa Blanca cartel. But that wasn't their main job. See, Yuri and Polito know about the human body. They know how much pain a person can endure before he'll die. They know how to keep a person alive and awake so they can feel the pain. And most of all, they know how to inflict that pain. That's what they do in Itaqua province. When Santa Blanca captures someone that refuses to talk, La Yuri and El Polito make them talk. They break people. Like I said, there were 4 people in the room the night Ricky Sandoval was murdered. Sueño, Ricky, Yuri, and Polito. They kept Ricky alive while Sueño tortured him. nonstop, for 47 hours straight. They broke Ricky Sandoval. Then Sueño executed him.
I'm riding the motorcycle.
I'll catch up with you.
Nomad, I've got Pacatari on the line. Sounds like he needs our help.
Put him through.
Hola, compadre. I have a problem in Itaqua, and Bowman says you may be able to help. My people need help. There have been many losses to the cartel, and the horrors inflicted by Yuri Polito have broken their spirit. The fires of revolution have almost gone out.
Spare me the rhetoric, Atari. Just tell me what you need.
There is a cartel supply convoy passing through the province soon. Capturing it would give my people much-needed supplies and restore their morale. Can you do this?
Consider it done.
Taking orders from Pat Katari now?
Katari needs this convoy. We are gonna give it to him. The more he depends on us to get shit done, the more we can get out of him in return. He's history.
Clear on this side. Go ahead, I'll meet you.
Looks like these Unidad guys want to sling some lead.
The drone is up.
Oh,
Things have been a little crazy around here the last couple days. Santa Blanca even made the news in the States. And though that sounds cool for a criminal enterprise, it's not.
Drone is up.
Look alive. We got company. I got one narco, near the food container.
What can you tell us about any of your recent patients and how you treated them? Por ejemplo, I know our listeners are very curious about a gringo who was recently your guest.
Oh, he is my gringo. Senor Ricky, what a guy. We knew him socially, you know.
Yo, cartel gunman, close to that nasty-looking dump. Watch your fire. We don't want to hit any civilians.
Sure, but, you know, I said, mean, when we break a leg, people know.
Tango
when
down.
Shadow the champions replace us.
I think they found their path. Get down before they see.
Target carrying submachine guns.
We're just taking a break in our all corrido, all the time programming to let you know that Santa Blanca's own internet sensation, La Plaga, now has a new website. You can find his personal blog and all the video content you can handle.
I got a narco over here, over by the helo.
These supplies will buy us a lot of goodwill from the rebels.
Oye, Yuri, how long has that guy been hanging there?
Yo no sé, amor. Maybe 12 hours?
Is he still alive? Check if he's breathing.
Ah, él está muerto. He's dead. He must have choked to death under that hood. Look at that boner.
Mierda, I told you the hood was too tight.
That's a big boner. I'm taking his pants off.
Yuri.
Ay. Are you jealous of a corpse, Biscocho?
What the hell, Yuri?
Whoa, ooh. This dead guy cock stinks like shit. And he could have learned some grooming or something, but damn. It's like a chorizo that got rolled around in dog hair.
Will you help me cut him down already?
Or like somebody peeled a banana, covered it in butterscotch and, whoops, dropped it on the barber shop floor?
Yuri, knock it off.
Oh, it's starting to stop.
Got it, moving.
Now it looks like a duke and a half and shake for a month.
Amor, por favor.
Say the word.
Get your face out of there.
I'm opening fire.
Target down. Here's target number 5.
Get bail. Get poison.
Follow me.
I've got the target. Enemy down. Tangos are marked. What's the word?
Roger. Target acquired. Lost my target.
We got civilians dangerously close. Check your targets before you shoot.
Hostile down.
Hang back before they spot you.
This document mentions an Unidad captain who sends prisoners to Urian Polito for interrogations. He's got to know where our lovebirds are, but he's sitting in an Unidad firebase. Open fire.
Esto es justito lo que quería. Comidita para las armas.
Yeah, I found details on the NSB supply helicopter. All we have to do is hijack it and deliver it to the rebels. Simple, right? Buckle up, people.
We recruit the people we know. Amigos from la calle. Duros we might meet in prison. And we may see something in these hombres that we like. Something that has potential. But the boy who asked the question, what makes a good sicario, was asking because he wanted to know who he should be, who he should become. There are many qualities that a good sicario must try to have. Cojones, strength, rifle, cunning. Very few men in this world have all these gifts, but in truth, a man needs none of them to be a good sicario. The only thing a man
drone is airborne. Got another tango.
Target marked.
Target's marked. Standing by for go order.
Ready
I got
to
one
fire.
Narco.
Point him out. I got a third target.
¿Qué pedo con tu vieja? No te mal viajes, compa.
Engaging.
That guy's history.
Okay, we're still good. Yo, cartel gunman, by the helo.
Just spotted one with submachine guns.
In position. Target's marked. Just say the word.
Target acquired. Standing ready. Call the shot. He's down.
Got the target.
Como que parece que va a llover hoy.
Ready to engage. Kill confirmed. Target set, ready to assault.
Eyes on the target.
Have a shot.
Got it.
We're clear. There's a cartel commendation here. We got a 20 in the garage where Polito parks his sports car. We snag that, we snag his GPS. Maybe something there tells us where he and his girlfriend are. Think I can wear this with my Class A uniform?
I'll pilot.
To the market, Jeeves. So how brutal is Yuri and Polito's torture anyway? I sure as hell don't want to find out. But I mean, obviously it's nothing as softball as waterboarding, right? I mean, we're talking permanent damage and death here.
They're also medically trained, so you have to figure there are some pharmaceuticals at work to keep their victims awake.
See, back in the day, the real torturers didn't need drugs to keep their victims awake. So they're amateurs. That's obvious from how few people survive their interrogations. A real torturer, a professional. He or she is in control. He or she understands what's needed. Yuri and Polito are sloppy. They get carried away. They do it for the fun of it, not because it's a job and not for the art. So yes, they're brutal, but not because they try to be. They're brutal because they're incompetent.
You got a dark side hidden under that smile, don't you? Enemy spotted.
I see a second target. I got a third.
Drone is up. That makes five. Got the target.
Good to go.
That's it, we're clear. think with all their money, the cartel would make a nicer metal.
Let's roll.
No venimos a ver si podíamos. Venimos porque podíamos. Santa Blanca Radio. Todo el poder de México transmitiendo con 100.000 watts de potencia. Santa Blanca Radio. La voz de los patrones.
Yo, I just saw this shit on TV. Este vato called the American Drug Czar. Which, by the way, qué chingados are you gonna be a 70-year-old white dude who never blazed in your life and call yourself a drug czar? Anyway, so this vato cabrón czar is going on and on about how the citizens in Mexico need to stand up and take back their country from the cartels y los pinches políticos. What? Oh, that's what they gotta do? Well, how about this? You want less cocaína in your country? Tell la raza to stop buying it. You want cartels to stop killing people? Stop selling them guns. You want to get rid of the drug lords? Stop putting them on the CIA payroll. But most important, stop blaming other people for your fucking problems. Simple as that.
Complete the total loss. Mission's over. We're done.